of the HEX Consortium, I would like to welcome you to our 2016 Best Practices Showcase, celebrating technology innovation for Hispanic success in higher education. My name is Maritza Rodriguez, and I will be in charge of introducing the speaker of this breakout session. This session is being recorded. The presenter will let you know whether you will be able to address your question at any time during the presentation or after the presentation has finished. This presentation will be delivered in English. Simultaneous translation is available in Channel 3. Additional telephones are available in the exhibitor area at the Rotunda. We will appreciate if you change your mobile phone to vibration or silent mode in order to have your full attention to this session. Finally, we will distribute the evaluation form. Please make sure to complete it before session is over and hand it in before you leave this room. Now we are ready to start. The presenter for this session is Carlos Morales and David Pearse. His biography information was included in the conference app and website. The title of this presentation is Accelerate Completion, a Weekend College in 18 Months. Please welcome Carlos and David.
Good morning. Introduction. My name is Carlos Morales, and I am a president of Tarrant County College District. This is on a campus, and of course, via Skype this morning. I apologize for not being in presence this morning, but due to other commitments, I had to stay here in Fort Worth, Texas. With me this morning is David Pearse. David.
Good morning.
Hi, David.
Okay. So with that said, we're going to go ahead and start with the presentation. We have an agenda of topics for us to pretty much follow and go and provide you information about our weekend college program that we developed for towards the completion agenda, which is something that is very well mentioned in the United States and certainly in Puerto Rico as well as part of the need to produce more students. As you see, we'll provide you general information about how this came into fruition, also information about our college, our campus, and then the different elements that we have put into motion to develop the weekend college operation that we will expand through this session. Let me start by providing you with the background of TCC Connect. TCC Connect is the sixth campus of Tarrant County College District. We are a system of now six campuses, five of them traditional face-to-face campuses, and the sixth campus is TCC Connect and is part of a strategic plan or commonly known as Vision 2015 for the district. In this case, two points of that strategic plan aim at increasing access to more educational opportunities, to different modalities, and also to address new modes of learning. With that said, the campus was grounded and developed under a non-traditional approach to serve non-traditional students. That means, in many organizations that may have different definitions, but for us is what we commonly know as people with life issues, and that means, you know, family responsibilities, work, difficult schedules during the day that impedes them to attend a traditional 8 to 5 or actually 5 to 10 p.m. traditional schedule, and they can and they want to do things at different times. This campus was established in 14 months. David is one of the original set off of members, part of the team that started this program, and he will expand on his role throughout the presentation. But one important element is that this campus is the work and the result of that work in terms of centralization. Currently, we are serving 26,000 student enrollments. We have 450 faculty members, and we deliver this with approximately 100 full-time staff members. We have 18 fully online programs, and we serve and deliver 350 plus online courses. One additional element on PCC Connect is that we are comprised of three modalities. They are e-learning and the distribution of students. You are seeing that in the slide, 19,000 in e-learning, 7,200 students in dual credit, and that could be understood also as concurrent enrollment in some quarters. But here in Texas, the state is very very strong in creating opportunities for students and is investing heavily in the workforce by creating conditions for students to attain higher education. And a way to do that is by doing dual credit at an early stage. And students, the students we are serving start in 11th and 12th grade, but with the recent law that was approved last May, now students can start taking college courses in 9th grade. We have a weekend college, which David is the director, and we have approximately 575 students. You see the demographic distribution of our campus, 32% male, 67% female, maybe similar to what many of you experience in your campus. You see the ethnicity breakdown here, 49% white, 18% African American, 21% Hispanic. We are a Hispanic serving institution designated by the Department of Education, 6% Asian and 2% multiracial. That's the composition of our campus. One additional element that I want to mention is the reasoning behind the campus again, and it has to do with the fact that we are aiming and we are helping the district and the state and the country to address a perennial problem in community college. And that is students usually graduate with more than 90 credits when they are required to complete only 60 credits. An associate's degree by design is 60 credits, and more than that could be 72 in very special programs. But as we said, this program contributes to the national completion agenda while allowing students to transfer to a four-year institution to pursue a four-year degree at a faster rate. We also see this as a way to reduce time towards graduation while increasing graduation rates. The next slide that you see here, we use part of the topic or the title to explain what we are seeing, and then if you can advance so the big numbers can be displayed. What you see here is information from the Texas the coordinating board, the Texas Higher Education Coordinating Board Almanac. It's a publication that gets distributed annually, and it covers information or provides information from or for all institutions in Texas. And on average, our students take 4.8 years to graduate with 92 semester credit hours. And the big numbers you see on the right, an associate's degree requires 60 credits, and students can do it in 18 months or less, is the way we are doing it in PCC Connect. So David, go and take it away with the next one, please. Yes. Go ahead.
Okay. So we also have student services that are available for all of our students. The idea is a lot of people who would come into a non-traditional class, such as a weekend class, such as a dual credit class, they often feel that they don't have the same benefits as everyone else does. The library is closed, the bookstore is closed, cafeteria is closed, and they want to be able to have the same opportunities. So with our online environment, we were able to get the online writing center. We have online tutors 24/7, and we have online advising. So these students from wherever they were would have an opportunity to have the same benefits as any other student would.
And David, let me just add this part. By accreditation requirements, and we are in the SACS accrediting area, we are required to provide equivalent services to students in online or off-campus locations. So that's why you see this set of services developed. The other element that I wanted to mention is that we created the accelerated weekend college using a cohort model, and David will expand on that. The program starts from a hybrid model. In this case, it starts pretty much, you know, online and moves to face-to-face. And, you know, once that starts, it's back and forth. We also provide high touch to students. Again, keep in mind that the accelerated version is for students that can commit to the pace of an accelerated program by taking two classes during the weekends, you know, one day during the weekend, either Friday or Saturday. And also we have developed learning communities.
So offer two different options. You may attend classes on Friday evening from 5 till 10 p.m. So offer two different options.
Okay, so basically, I have been called by Houston.
So offer two different options. You may attend classes on Friday evening from 5 till. The student of the weekend.
I think you were rehearsing last night.
I don't remember last night.
There you go.
I did find out that Magna Beer is the beer of Puerto Rico. Okay, all right, I think that's it. Okay, good. So basically, I've been contacted by Houston and by Dallas Community Colleges saying, how come we have a community college, weekend college, that's not working and yours is? Yours is growing phenomenal, how come? And one of the reasons is because we have a focus, we've changed things a little bit around, which we're gonna talk about a lot throughout this presentation. But what we used to have, what was called the weekend college before, was basically classes that were being offered on the weekend that people just took whenever they wanted to. I call it like fishing, you know? You throw some classes out, you throw some English and some history and some government, and you hope students enroll for it. But the question is, when does it begin and when does it end? You know, you're just there offering classes. It's not the same thing as the weekend college. So the weekend college became an accelerated program where we would take students. Why is this moving?
It's moving. Okay.
Am I there?
We get a college.
Okay, all right. So a student can go with it.
Go by itself.
Okay. So this gives a student an opportunity to get their associate degree in 18 months or less by coming to school one day a week, either Friday or Saturday. So they could come either on Friday or Saturday, and then when they come either on Friday or Saturday, there's a flexible schedule for them, increased access for non-traditional busy adults. Now, when Weekend College was first done, here's something, you saw your statistics there. Here's something that's quite interesting. We always thought about the working adult who has a full-time job, who's full-time family, and this is the only time they have available, and that's kind of who we marketed to. And then as I started doing surveys of the students, I started finding out that who I got was a lot of housewives who said, I've been home all week with the kids, you get to stay and watch kids now, I'm going to school. So we end up with a lot of people who've been this homemaker for so many years, trapped inside the house, and now they got a chance to get out because it was a time when daddy was home to watch the kids. So you see that 67% female, a lot of those are those people who've been out of the workforce, out of the education for a long time, very, very much non-traditional. We have a convenient central location, and it's a pathway where you get your curriculum 1 year. In 1 year, you get your core curriculum 42 hours out of the way. So we end up with technology with the hybrid delivery, which I'll explain here. So we have this. There we go. So if you come in on Friday night, what we do on Friday night is we meet between 5 and 10 p.m. And 5 and 10 p.m. is going to give us a five-hour slot there. We do two classes for 7 weeks, followed by two classes for 7 weeks. So it's a little bit, it's an accelerator. You're doing it twice as fast. Four classes a semester makes you a full-time student, doing two at a time. And so when you come into class, what we do is every week we have what's called student development. And the student development is we meet with you, the whole group of students together, no matter what class you're taking. We talk about your learning styles. We talk about note-taking skills. We talk about how do you highlight a textbook. We talk about how do you access the library. How do you transfer? How do you complete a FAFSA form? So we meet with the students every week, and we give them a chance to learn more, to be more successful students. Now, the nice thing about it is some people get off at 5 o'clock, and you know what? I can't make it there at 5 o'clock. By doing the student development between 5 and 6, if they come in at 5:30, they're still going to learn something. So it helps them out with that. And we do the first class between 6 and 8, and the second class between 8 and 10. On Saturday, they come in, same format, except they do the first class between 9 and 11. Then we do an hour of student development, so bring your lunch, sit down with us. A lot of students are bringing their family members or bringing their friends into the student development because this is a really interesting subject. I'd like for my husband to know about this, you know, so they bring their families in and other students in, and then their second class will be between 12 and 2. So as you see on here, we have learning styles, time management, that's one of those very important things. So we end up with having about 25% face-to-face and about 75% online. Now the benefit of this is online classes are fantastic, but I've been in higher education for 23 years, and what I can tell you is that I usually hear from the student, I'll do it a little bit later. You know, I'll get around to it. I'll get around to doing my homework. And when they end up getting to the very end of their class and realize they've got 15 papers that are due, or the face-to-face classes where you have to meet two, three, four times a week, which is too much. So by doing this, they know they have a timeline. They know they're going to be meeting every week. And by meeting every week, they're going to make sure that they have their homework done. Matter of fact, one of the quotes from, and I love stealing, I mean borrowing quotes from my students. One of the very first students that I had come through there said, if you wait till Tuesday to do your homework, you're behind. And they share that with all the other students, and the other students go, oh, I better not put this off. And they end up staying on top of it. And it's ended up being very successful by going through that way. So what kind of students do we have? And I've got to tell you that as much as I would love to market this to every single student, this is not a class for everybody. You can't do this. Now I've got 30 years in the healthcare field. I've been a paramedic for 30 years and teaching EMS classes for a number of years. I'm really good with anatomy and physiology. I would never do an A&P class in 7 weeks. Okay, and I know that subject, okay, it's just too much. So there are a certain amount of classes, there are a certain amount of students that we have that can get into this class. First thing we have in the state of Texas, we have what's called TSI, and the TSI took the place of AccuPlacer and what were some of those other SAT, you know, some of those other placement tests that they took?
ACT
Compass.
Compass.
So basically the TSI, Texas State Initiative, said you come in, you take your test, and you see what level of reading, what level of writing, what level of math that you're in. If you are not TSI met in reading and writing, you're not getting into my classes. In other words, we have no developmental classes. So people who are not English level proficient or ready for the first class are not going to get into my class. We find that a lot of students are not TSI met in math. But when you look at the schedule, we're not going to hit math until our fourth semester, so we'll work with you on that one there. You can take developmental classes on your own for math to bring yourself up to that level. The student, we try to get them first time in college. And it said should be because we work around that. When we talk about first time in college, we start you off, the very first two classes you take are English and history, followed by English and history. You know you're going to be writing for the rest of your college career.